HIV Week on ESPN as we continue Jim Valvano's fight against cancer.
Welcome to Penn State. It will be rocking here at the Bryce Jordan Center. It's the Big Ten on ESPN. Penn State hosts the number 4 team in America. Maryland comes to State College as Mark Turgeon's team looks to stay undefeated. And the student section started to fill up about 2 hours ago. And now they're all here ready for basketball, and so are we. Hagen, everyone, Bob Wachusett alongside Dan Dockage. Thanks for spending part of your evening with us. This is a tough spot that Maryland's walking into. Earlier today, if you check the line, Maryland was a slight favorite. Now they're a slight underdog against the unranked Penn State team.
Well, the reason is Penn State's a veteran crew. They have a dynamic duo. Lamar Stevens is one of the great players in Penn State history. He's a two-way. He's inside out. He's big. He's strong. He can go on the block. And then the guy you see right there, number 24, Mike Watkins. Mike Watkins is the NCAA's active leader in blocks. You can make the argument how that kid goes, Penn State goes. They got whooped by Ohio State. And Mike Watkins had nothing for Caleb Wesson. I'm guessing you're going to see Mike Watkins and Lamar Stevens play great for Penn State.
Home court has meant a lot between these two teams. They have alternated wins and losses on each other's home floor. The last six consecutive meetings, the home team has won.
Yeah, and this is as good a crowd as Penn State's had in a long time, and it's Jack. You said it, a couple hours before the game, people are here lined up, students are lively.
Stevens and Watkins, they certainly are the two players that spearhead the offensive charge for the Nittany Lions, and what a start on the alley-oop to Watkins for the first flush of the game. Talking to Mark Turgeon earlier today, and we talked about their last game, a game he couldn't believe they pulled out by one on Saturday against Illinois. Said, look, we had Anthony Cowan, and they didn't, and that was the difference at the end of the game. Cowan tries to go backdoor on the opening possession, and it's a turnover. Miles Dredd buries a three.
Well, you're going to see that type action. You see it all the time. Set a screen in the middle of the lane, receive a screen. Happens almost every possession at some point.
Aaron Wiggins with a skip pass and the answer by Jalen Smith.
Bobby, Penn State really likes to help, and you can watch in the lane where Penn State gets. The skip pass is going to be there, particularly when you got a guy in Stick Smith that can shoot the step-in jump shot. You saw already Penn State trying to get the ball to Watkins on the dunk. They're doing it right here. They got to get him engaged, Bob.
Watkins spins baseline, comes up short, and gets walled off nicely by the freshman, Makai Mitchell. It and finishes and ties the game.
Oh, I love him. I mean, he is strong, Bob. When he gets going down the lane, he cups the ball. He makes his best jump, shoots it over, around, whatever he needs.
Lamar Stevens, yes. He's been in double figures every game so far for Penn State and off to a good start here.
Big and strong. He's playing against Smith, but Smith's got some height on him, but Stevens, bigger, stronger, and a senior.
Wiggins, nice bounce pass. Unable to finish, though, was Mitchell.
How about Watkins, Bob? Got a dunk, got a block.
Jamari Wheeler can't connect. Another rebound for Mitchell. Ayala step back. Knocks another one down.
Ayala was moved into the starting line. He didn't start for his couple games. Won a game for him, really, against Temple, first game in Orlando. Put him in the middle of the floor, gets things done.
Old school floater high off the glass for Myron Jones.
All right, Bob, we got defense optional? Or is this just good offense?
There's a little open gym at the start of this game. How about that reverse on the try by Ayala?
Man, that's good offense. The great Bart Fox in my ear telling me I'm the analyst, but sometimes I like to ask questions. What'd you say, a little open gym? There's not a lot of pressure on the ball. You see, everybody's comfortable. There's not a lot of hand action. And when you're comfortable, you shoot it in, you drive it, and you turn it over occasionally.
They would have called that one an open gym as well on Ayala.
I'm a big fan, Bob. I think he's terrific. You see where he is, fourth. He struggled. He fouled out on a technical foul against Ohio State. Only played 17 minutes. I thought it was ridiculous. Technical foul.
That's Taylor Battle, the number one scorer in the history of Penn State basketball, here to take in tonight's game.
Watch off the ball. They just ran it again. They set a screen, bringing Stevens to the left post, mid post as well. And then they set a screen for Dredd. Dredd's the best shooter. He hunts threes. And Stevens, the best mid post guy.
Said it's Jones leaning in. Gets his own miss. Puts it up again. That won't go. And the rebound to Callum. Sticks. Smith lost it on the way up. Isaiah Brockington, coast to coast.
All right, now that's bad defense. You can't take the ball the length of the court. Somebody, Mitchell, Smith, somebody's got to stop the basketball. Brockington saw the same lane that we saw and just went to the rim.
Aaron Wiggins out to Cowan. Nice ball movement. Corner jumper for Ayala won't go. Ripped away by Smith. Stick Smith keeps it alive.
Think they want to get the ball to Cowan on the perimeter?
Instead, it's Mitchell. He shuffled his feet. The freshman turns it over, and a good start between Penn State and Maryland.
A lot of offense, not much defense. You'll see Cowan soon, though.
Off to a tight start between Maryland and Penn State. Bob Bushews and Dan Dockage, and Dan takes us inside the play.
All right, you think Anthony Cowan draws attention? Here's Cowan. Here are two defenders from Penn State. Watch what happens here. You got to get out to Cowan. Not one, but two guys go flying out on Anthony Cowan, and then the help comes, and there's a miss. Now, remember that play late, and I don't care how deep Cowan seems to be. He shoots deep late, and you've got to be out on him. Make somebody else beat you as a scouting report.
Well, Maryland trailed Illinois by 15 in the second half of what turned out to be a one-point win on Saturday. And Mark Turgeon told us earlier today, we had Anthony Cowan. That's how we ended up winning the game.
As simple as that.
Reach-in foul called on Eric Ayala. Well, coming up next over on ESPN at 9 Eastern, the 25th annual Jimmy V Classic will roll on. The second game of that doubleheader between Indiana and UConn. And you can always watch it live on the ESPN app.
Indiana, weird team. Played great against Florida State and then laid an egg at Wisconsin. Wisconsin has been really struggling. But that'll be a good one. Danny Hurley's UConn Huskies play hard.
Stevens buries a three.
You know, Bob, what we said about Cowan, you can say about Stevens. I mean, you can't let Stevens beat you. He's going to be one of the top five all-time leading scorers. And maybe the best all-around player Penn State's seen in a long, long time. He's fourth now, excuse me.
Cowan hasn't scored yet. Shot clock down to 10.
They switched everything to him. Harris on him now. Got to get your hands up, though.
Jump stop for Cowan. Way off the mark. 1 second to shoot. Well, it's hard to believe it's been almost a decade now that Patrick Chambers has been on the sidelines at Penn State. A couple of years ago, won the NIT. Last season, 14-18, a disappointing year. And let's see the quick trigger here and a takeaway. Era knocked it right into his own hands.
Yeah, and he had his hands up. You've got to play defense with your hands exposed.
Stevens to the goal again. That's rejected by Stick Smith. Cowan. That's knocked away cleanly. Double dribble. Dante Scott turns it over.
I thought Cowan got killed. You said clean?
Look clean to me.
Refs agree.
A minute ago, you were complaining there was no defense. Now you want fouls called.
No,
these guys take it to the basket.
I never want fouls called. I think referees should be judged by how few fouls they call. Here it is.
Well, this group's getting high marks early.
That was the same action, Bob. Back screen, but they didn't set it. They cleared aside for Brockington, and he just missed it.
An airmail pass for Jalen Smith, and he couldn't haul it in. Stevens throws one up top, but he is fouled. He got bumped by Dante Scott. Last nine possessions for Maryland. They turned it over six times, and yet they only trail by four as Hara heads to the bench. Also sitting down, Myron Jones, as Mike Watkins is back in. Jamari Wheeler returns as well.
The reason they've turned it over is they haven't been patient to swing the ball. Every time they've swung the ball a few times, good things have happened.
No good from the corner for Watkins. The quick outlet to Ayala from Cowan. Stick Smith hit the deck.
Same thing there. They were getting ready to turn that over. Ayala was driving into Watkins, and the defense will rotate. But if you move Penn State side to side, you can get pretty much whatever you want.
Ayala was banged up on that play as well, as Maryland with only one assist to seven turnovers already. Penn State hasn't turned it over as Ayala goes to the bench. And Darryl Morcell sits down as well.
Put your hands up.
He'll drive it instead. Cowan leans in. Still can't score his first basket. And it looks like over the back will be called on Stick Smith as he climbed up near the head of Mike Watkins.
Bobby, it's the same thing. I mean, you're driving against a stacked defense. Penn State is fantastic in help defense. So what do? You swing the basketball, which makes them play from inside out. That's when they make mistakes, and you can drive it.
Nice finish. The flip with the left hand by Isaiah Brockington. Picks one to the corner. Can't pick up an assist, and he still does not have a basket, but the carom ends up with Maryland. Scott down the lane. Floats one. A little too strong. Watkins able to clear the quick outlet. Swooping to the goal. Tip followed by Wheeler. Off the miss from Brockington.
Well, that was terrific by Wheeler. I'm looking at the scouting report of Brockington. Don't let him go left.
Well, he's a lefty.
And he went left twice. One time for the layup. The other time, the help came, opened up the backboard.
Hesitation, dribble, and Cowan turns it over. A 9-0 Penn State run as Bryce Jordan rocking.
Don't let him go left. It says right here in the scouting report, Brockington. Well, he goes left. Guess what? He finishes over the much bigger Smith.
Eight turnovers already for Maryland, a team that only averages about 11 and a half turnovers per game.
Yeah, and you see the hands of Penn State. Very aggressive right there. There's your hands again. Now, important hand pressure is, I can't even explain it to you, because if you don't get your hands involved, the offense gets comfortable. And Mark Turgeon's team can handle the basketball from about four spots, Bob. Bunch of guys that can shoot it. Penn State's done a great job of hand activity.
Penn State, number one in the Big Ten in turnovers forced per game. That's working. But you would not think that they would be able to turn Maryland over at this rate. That's been the biggest factor so far in the early 8-point Nittany Lion lead. Watkins trying to bully his way inside. Instead, hands one off to Wheeler. Back up top for a rainbow jumper. That is buried by Miles Trent.
Miles Trent shoots it like that. Maryland has a problem. And what I liked about what Penn State did, they played inside out. Watkins could have forced that shot. He didn't. They got three out of it.
Ayala right at Watkins, and Watkins is called for the first foul against Penn State. Great doubleheader on ESPN and the ESPN app this Saturday afternoon. Starts with a bitter rivalry game between Penny Hardaway's Tigers and Rick Barnes Vols in Knoxville at 3 Eastern. And then John Calipari and number 8 Kentucky will host Georgia Tech in Lexington. So a good doubleheader beginning at 3 in the afternoon. I'll actually be in Knoxville with Dick Vitale for game number 1 of that doubleheader. And by the way, at halftime over on ESPN of the Indiana-UConn game at the Jimmy V Classic, Dick is going to do a speech talking about all the money that's been raised over the years and an exciting announcement as well for cancer research. So hopefully everyone will tune in to that, because the work that he does along with his foundation, tireless, and boy, they raise a lot of money for the V Foundation.
No, there's no question, and Dickie V is the best. I mean, you said it, you work with him all the time, so you see it, and it's real. And this is not just for TV.
Watkins seals inside and scores.
Boy, what a great pass. Again, when you play with the ball on top, it spreads the defense. There's no help. So you throw it over the top. Watkins against Morcell. You got a mismatch. They abused Morcell.
Hands. Miles Dredd with the steal. Drops one off, an extra shovel pass to Stevens. He got caught under the basket. Ayala the other way, finds Morcell. Morcell will cruise in. Offensive foul.
What hustle by Dredd, getting back and getting set up outside the arc. Whew. Dredd went flying. This looked like it was going to be a layup. Look at Dredd get set and outside the arc. All right, let me show you Watkins right here. See this match right here? The ball is in the middle of the court, so nobody else is in the lane. Smith comes over, but late help, you always give up a bucket. You can't help when the ball is on top. Great recognition by Stevens.
Is being on pace for 40 turnovers bad?
It's not great.
That's where Maryland is right now. As Watkins spins baseline, hit the side of the backboard. Here comes Ayala the other way.
Yeah, pretty good by Mitchell, taking away Watkins' left shoulder.
Ayala picks one to the corner. And that's a much-needed three as it was knocked down by Dante Scott. The freshman is able to ring the bell and make it a 7-point game. And that stops a field goal drought of over 7 minutes for the Terps. And now a call is going to go against Jamari Wheeler, setting a moving screen.
You've seen that all year. I mean, you hand off, I hand off to you. If I turn my body, it's automatic, and Larry Scrotto was all over.
What have you thought of the rules changes this season, the step back of the three-point line being much more cognizant of flopping, some of the things that have played big roles, I think, early in this college basketball season?
I don't know, you know. Look at that. I think the three-point line has had an effect. I think, you know, marginal shooters aren't making it. And I think for a kid like Cowan, it doesn't matter to him, but for a lot of kids it does. The flopping rule, I don't know. I think it puts officials in a bad spot. What do you think?
How so?
Well, you got to determine, is he flopping, is he not? You go to I don't like anything where you have to go to the monitor. And that's one of those, Bob, you got to go to the monitor all the time.
You do. Zarrell Smith, tough pass to handle, and it's another Maryland turnover. Good hands by Myron Jones.
Two turnovers in a row. One was thrown to the scorer's table because of an arm hand in the passing lane. The other was banged off this side scorer's table because the defense right there gets their hands involved. It's a little thing, and it was done fundamentally sound. The proper hand, right hand in the lane. There's your screen to screener. Here's your three.
And Dredd connects again. Timeout called by Mark Turgeon. Miles Dredd red hot. The Penn State fans having fun. And we'll step aside for 30 seconds. Kevin, thanks very much. John Crispin, we'll hear from him at halftime, of course, former Penn Stater, who spent part of his collegiate career here in State College. And the Nittany Lions have capitalized on a terrific shooting performance so far by Miles Dredd, the always consistent Lamar Stevens, but it's also been the sloppy play by Maryland in the first half as they've got 12 turnovers. They only average 11 and a half a game.
And they've been badly. I mean, they've been, like I said earlier, throw them to the scoreboard bad. Couple turnovers for touchdown. Haven't heard anything out of Wiggins, a kid with the ball. Haven't heard anything out of Cowan. Look at the hand action.
Ayala's been probably the best offensive player that they've had so far. Cowan's still looking for his first basket. He's going to have to force one up with four to shoot. That's in and out. And a rebound pulled down by Lamar Stevens. Hera, short, right back to it. Stevens lost it.
Coach, I was open. There's a reason you're open. And you just saw the reason Hera was open.
Ayala steps back. He's got it.
The only guy, you said it, Bob. You cannot let Eric Ayala into the lane. You think you have him, you don't. He's got a variety of moves, fakes, fades. He's the only guy doing anything right now offensively.
In double figures already for the seventh time in the first 11 games. Brockton can't hit. It's tapped out of bounds by Makai Mitchell. That'll bring Watkins back in for Hera. And it looks like Jamari Wheeler will come back on as well, as he will take out Isaiah Brockington.
Well, both Brockington and Hera did a really good job. You know, everybody that's played for Penn State thus far has been really tough defensively and gotten their hands involved and gotten a deflection or two.
Myron Jones. And the rebound is cleared. Nearly turned over on the outlet pass by Mitchell. Ayala. Can't connect from long range. Gets his own miss. Attacks the basket. Flips it off the rim. And it's tracked down in the corner.
Great defense by Watkins to go straight up.
Heat check. And maybe check it again if you're Miles Dredd. As I'm not sure anybody would be that hot.
I even heard the fans behind us get stoops on that one.
Wiggins, he knocks one down in the mid-range, and a quick timeout called by Penn State. We'll step aside for 30 seconds and come right back to the Bryce Jordan Center.
Number one is laugh. You should laugh every day. Number two is think. You should spend some time in thought. And number three is you should have your emotions moved to tears. Could be happiness or joy. But think about it. If you laugh, you think, and you cry, that's a full day. That's a heck of a day.
That was 1993.
It's unbelievable.
That's how long ago that was. And I have showed that speech to my kids. Because to me, that's one of those moments, and I was watching it earlier today. They aired it, saw Hannah Storm wrapping around it on ESPN2. And, you know, there's certain things that when they're on television, like the end of It's a Wonderful Life, if that's on television, I'm watching it. It doesn't matter how many times I've seen it, I'm watching the end of that movie. If I see Jim Valvano giving that speech somewhere on TV, I'm stopping and I'm watching it, and every time he gets to the end, I get choked up the same way I did the first time I saw it.
I had you for half that. I've had enough of It's a Wonderful Life, but as a family, my son, my daughter, wife, we all sat every year. Every year I was coaching and watched that speech.
Yep.
June is on, and we all watched it, and I cry every time. In fact, hearing that, I got goosebumps. Cowan got going, by the way.
Cowan knocked one down. Stevens can't answer, but there's a back tap. That time a shot fake by Dredd. The old school floater rolls home.
That's what happens when you make a few, Bob. The shot fake works for you. Every kid playing college basketball as a guard has to have a shot fake and floater right where you see the Big Ten logo. If you don't have that, you can't play unless you're a great defender.
Cowan forces one up. Terrible shot, looking for a foul, and the officials didn't give it to him. Here's Ayala, though. Extra possession for Maryland. Dante Scott got shut down in the lane. Able to find Wiggins. And a nice rebound by Dredd. Watkins fades away. Short. Penn State has missed seven of their last eight. They still have a seven-point lead. And another turnover. Cowan throws it to Myron Jones. He gives it up to Wheeler.
Oh, Bobby Wheeler right in front of us. Sprinted the floor past everybody and was rewarded.
Watkins, he gets it back. Scott tries one. That's no good. Watkins clears. Myron Jones with the left hand and the follow by Watkins.
I talk about it all the time, Bob. Late help. Maryland was late to help. What that does, it opens up the backboard. Jones saw it, went to the rim, the follow. Nobody's there to block out because of late help.
Like lightning to the front of the rim.
Well, that was quick. Watkins didn't even see it. You got to attack Scott. You can't just settle for a fadeaway or step. There you go.
Lamar Stevens gives it up. And finishing again is Mike Watkins.
Yeah, you have to. Scott's a freshman. He's from Philly. He's dying to play in this game. Stevens is a senior. You don't fade away against a freshman. You go knock him out of the way and make a play.
Eight already for Watkins. Wiggins fouled. Points off turnovers for Penn State. They've lived off of it.
Watch the run out right there, number five. He's running past everybody. Don't jog back. Sprint. Sprint. I'll tell you this. They've driven the ball down the middle a lot. Hadn't worked. They got to move the ball around and then maybe dribble the ball into the middle of the lane, because that middle for Maryland or Penn State has jammed that thing up nice. Move them a little bit side to side and you'll get whatever you want.
A points in the paint right now. Penn State leads Maryland 22-6. To your point about putting the ball in the middle. And this week our NBA Wednesday doubleheader features some of the NBA's top teams. The Clippers and Kawhi in Toronto to take on Kyle Lowry. Pascal Siakam and the Raptors at 7 Eastern. Then Giannis and the Bucks host the Pelicans. Both games on ESPN and the ESPN app.
Man, was Paul George good yesterday. He came back to Indiana and unloaded on them. I mean, 38, did everything, and it wasn't even close. The Clippers came into Indianapolis and whooped up on them.
Let's go Lions! Let's go Lions! Let's go Lions!
Freshman Seth Lundy on the floor for the first time, wearing number one in white for Penn State, and leaning in and connecting is Curtis Jones.
Third school, went to Indiana, had 23 as a freshman against Kansas early in his career, ends up transferring to Oklahoma State, and now he's here. He's a bucket getter, and eventually, Pat Chambers told us, like to see him in the starting lineup.
Cowan rises up and connects.
This is an All-American.
Mara able to bank one off of Makai Mitchell to keep it with Penn State.
All right, let's talk about why that was a bad play by Wheeler. If you're going to throw the ball to Hera, the only thing Hera can do with it is catch it and lay it in. But if you're going to throw it for you guards out there, if you're going to throw a lob to a big guy running, always throw it too long, never too short. Too short means it's going to go back the other way in transition. Too long means it's either going to go to your guy or out of bounds. It's a bucket getter.
Jones can't hit.
This is the guy also that has to get going, Bob. He's won games for Marcel.
The freshman forces one up around Watkins. And Makai Mitchell couldn't get it on the rim, but it's out of bounds off Penn State.
The Achilles heel of Penn State, they've had a great start, is who's going to post up. The Mitchell brothers, they'll be really good, but not ready yet. Stick Smith can, but it's not his thing. Morsell, really good at it, actually, to make plays out of it. But that's kind of the Achilles heel.
Here is Morsell, driving it, comes up short.
Can't drive it anywhere, middle, side, unless you reverse the ball, because Penn State is in the lane.
One minute to go here in the first half. Dredd used the screen from Watkins. Watkins goes to the goal, and that pass hit the rim as Brockton was looking for the alley-oop. Cowan the other way. Cowan gets a return.
Wiggins had a layup. Didn't know he had it.
Crowd loves the defensive effort from the Nittany Lions as they recovered multiple times. Now there's nine to shoot. Wiggins, too strong, air ball. Weak side rebound, pulling the string. Makai Mitchell. It's still loose. Morsell can't hit. The tip follow finally goes. It looked like Ricky Lindo got a piece.
You know what's interesting? If we look at that, only once, I believe, in this offensive rebounding possession did anybody from Penn State jump. At least from my view of it, it looked like it was all, what color is that, red? It was all red. I mean, they jumped once maybe. Nobody jumping. You don't see anybody up in the air here. Nobody. Look at Watkins, he's behind. Nobody. 11, Stevens. Nobody's in the air to swat that. This feels bad for Penn State. It feels like they should be up double digits.
That was a five-shot possession before the fifth finally went in. Lamar Stevens double team, fades away, air ball. Saved, nope, stepping on the end line was Darryl Morsell. So little over a half second to go here in the first half.
There's a flop warning on number zero, Jones.
On the last possession at the other end.
Yeah.
So at least that's on the books as Bo Borowski fills us in. So Myron Jones has to be careful the rest of the way. There's the quick trigger from the corner. Oh, knocking it down is Jones. Mark Turgeon says, let's take a look. He doesn't think Myron Jones got the shot off. That's out of his hand.
That's a friendly clock. But she pumps it.
Mark Turgeon made the motion to the officials. Wait, he caught it, brought it down by his knees, and then up and shot it. It should not be something that should only take a half a second to get off, and yet it looked like that ball was out of the hands of Myron Jones with 0.2 seconds still on the clock.
Looked easy, didn't it? I mean, look, there's home court advantage. What are you going to do? The guy running the clock's a human being. I don't know how you could overturn this. I mean, this is, yeah, it's good.
That bucket counts for Myron Jones. So it is a 10-point lead at halftime for Penn State. Against Illinois on Saturday, Maryland was trailing by 14-1. Double digits
against Harvard, against Temple, you name it, they've been down against it.
Let's head back to Kevin and the guys in the studio for the halftime report.
SB Week on ESPN as we continue Jim Valvano's fight against cancer.
At the start of the night, we mentioned that Maryland had gone from a slight favorite to a slight underdog, which might be eyebrow-raising when you're number four and you're playing against a team that's unranked. And lo and behold, Penn State has the 10-point halftime lead. Bob Schuster and Dan Dockett just about set for the second half. And there were some trends in the first half that were big factors early and continued to roll all the way through the first 20 minutes, most notably how many turnovers Maryland committed and how Penn State took advantage and won the points off turnovers battle.
Yeah, left side of your screen, you see right there, points off turnovers. 13 turnovers by Maryland. 13. They average 11 for the game. But I got to give Penn State credit. They got their hands involved. They kept guys in front of them. Maryland got a little bit fast, but look at the number three. 7 points for Cowan, all in the last 6 minutes. Bob, I'm telling you, you're going to have to guard Cowan the last 10 minutes of this game. And you're going to have to guard him hard, or you're going to get beat.
And the top line there, something you mentioned early, it's been probably a disturbing trend for Mark Turgeon, kind of glass half full, glass half empty. His team has routinely found ways to come from behind in the second half. They're an undefeated team, but they keep on falling behind in the first half. And, you know, trailing at halftime is familiar territory for the Terps.
Trailing at halftime against Temple, first game in Orlando. Second game in Orlando against Harvard trailing. Down 14 and half. Here's another turnover.
And they start the second half off with a turnover, but Jamari Wheeler can't connect. Dick Smith spins baseline. Yes.
Hey, that was nice. I'll tell you why. Because when Smith turned into Watkins, he hit him with his shoulder, and Watkins couldn't jump because he was knocked off balance. That was a physical great move by Stick Smith. Lindo starting, gave him good energy into the half, number four in red.
Lamar Stevens kicks it back up top to Myron Jones. Watkins keeps it alive. Leans in and scores.
Melindo's in there for energy and to get that rebound. He didn't do it. Watkins went right back at him.
Wiggins, no good, but a foul call.
Double screen to bring Wiggins into the lane. Wiggins about 6'7", Bob. It's pretty good action by Mark Turgeon to start the second half. He's ran kind of a couple baseline actions, one for Cowan, one there for Wiggins.
That's the second foul on Watkins.
Number two, Aaron
Wiggins has gained about 20 pounds of muscle since he got to Maryland. Only a sophomore, and it shows, but he was the number nine small forward in all of America, according to our ESPN rankings. And along with Stick Smith, who has added 30 pounds to his frame, you can see number 25 leaning in there. Could you picture Jalen Smith 30 pounds lighter than he looks right now?
I remember last year doing a game. He was standing next to Bruno Fernando. And Bruno Fernando's a big dude. And Stick Smith looked exactly like his nickname. Period. There's that screen-to-screener action. Much better played by Wiggins. Wiggins is a pretty good defender when he sits down and wants to get in the passing lane.
Lamar Stevens with the shot clock winding down. Gives one up to Watkins for the flush.
It's hard to guard Stevens. You got to figure this out. That's the go-to move, mid-post. I call it the Bonzi Wells area. He was terrific with Memphis. He makes plays as kind of a point post-up forward. Same action, double down.
Ayala, quick trigger. In and out. Stick Smith, offensive rebound, but lost control. Stevens brings it back.
I'm sorry, Bob. He lost control because he went running in under the bucket, and the rebound bounded out long. If he'd have just stayed where he was, he had it. Well, Wheeler's doing a good job, number five. On Cowan. I don't think Cowan scored against Wheeler yet.
He's got seven. Shut down by Watkins. Smith, offensive rebound. But it looks like it's going to go to Penn State. And they're going to call a foul on Stick Smith.
This is a tough, tough guard right here. Lindo trying. And he just doesn't, he's just not big enough, strong enough. And this is on Stick Smith, which I'm not sure why that would be a foul.
And they called him for going over the back of Jamari Wheeler. I think that was a foul for being tall.
I was going to say, ex-referee Steve Wellmer, the whale, who's 6'7", was doing that. He wasn't calling that a foul. Tough guard.
Wheeler keeps it alive. Throws it back up top off the miss by Stevens. Byron Jones floats one intended for Watkins, but it was read beautifully.
And that's what I said. When you throw lobs short, transition the other way. Always throw a lob pass long where only your guy or it goes out of bounds, because this happens. Lob short. Here we go. Off to the races. Pretty good job attacking the rim.
That foul on Stevens, his first. So Ricky Lindo is at the free throw line for the first time tonight. 50% in a small sample size so far this season. Knocks down the first.
Number 12, Isaiah Brockington.
And coming up next over on ESPN at 9 Eastern, it's the 25th annual Jimmy V Classic rolling on from the Garden. Game number two between Indiana and UConn. You can always watch it live on the ESPN app. How about IU and the start there off two with Archie Miller?
One of the weakest schedules in the country, had a great win over Florida State. I think Florida State's legit, and then laid an egg at Wisconsin. And Danny Hurley, his team plays hard, and he's kind of a maniac on the sidelines like his dad.
I'll tell you, Dan Hurley is now having it put on him, I think. He's the most important, not just sports figure, but figure now at UConn, because they're taking their football program, they're going independent, and I think they're counting on the basketball program to go back to where the basketball program used to be, and then bringing the football program along with it the next time, say, an ACC looks to expand maybe. You know, right now that they're kind of caught in between as Wiggins
Gino
knocks that
the
one down.
One guy?
Well,
I know what you're saying.
As great as the women's basketball program has been, that hasn't been enough to make that athletic program as a whole attractive enough, say, to a Big 12 or an ACC or a Big 10. Amar Stevens connects again, and Penn State maintains their lead. Double figures again for Lamar Stevens, all 10 games so far this season for the Nittany Lions. Cowan pulls up, line drive.
Great defense, Wheeler.
Wheeler got a piece, and here comes Wheeler. A lob. Off the backboard somehow, Brockington, softly enough to let it drop through.
Mark turns it all over Larry Scrotto. Felt like Cowan got hit by Wheeler. Wheeler all over Collin.
Wiggins, tough shot.
There's your foul.
There is a foul call.
Hey, that was because Turgeon, it was number one because he fouled him, but Turgeon was going crazy on the guy right there, Larry Scarano, one of the great guys in college basketball. Both of them, actually. Let's see. Oh, yeah. How do you miss that? Kind of a big call, Bobby. You know why? Because they're laying it in on the other end.
At v.org/donate, all donations benefit the V Foundation for cancer research, as we are all at ESPN trying to continue the mission of Jim Valvano and someday eradicate cancer.
I'm Sherry Mazur, Vice President of the V Foundation, on my radio show. 100% every donation goes to cancer research. 100%. It's awesome.
I think Dickie V said it's up to $250 million total. That's what I heard him say, that we have raised over the years for the V Foundation.
I believe the $250 million is what has been
allocated to cancer research.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah. How about
a quarter of $1 billion? There are not many unbeatens left. Maryland and Louisville, though, are on the list. And number one and number four in their respective games, both in the second half, both trailing.
Ohio State looked really, really good. They've got a week off before they go to Minnesota. Butler, tough one tonight. They're playing Baylor. San Diego State is very good. Had a chance to watch them, and I'm not going to lie to you, I haven't seen Duquesne or Liberty.
Is it a good time to be a Buckeye sports fan?
Not bad.
These days? Are you enjoying the games when you click on your TV?
Oh, my God.
My goodness. Stevens gets shut down, gets it back, 10 to shoot. Clock winding down, four to shoot, and that forces Curtis Jones to launch from way outside.
If I was Maryland, I'd just keep pushing it and let the ball move. from Morcell. They never set up. They didn't get into a set. Morcell just does what Morcell does, plays well second half. Look at his strength on Morcell, because Brockington, the man he's going up against, hits him pretty hard. I'm a big fan of this kid. He told me after they won it in Orlando on television, hey, I'm a winner. He just said it in a post-game interview. He's great.
Averages about 9 points per game, but is a player that always seems to be that X-factor guy that Mark Turgeon gives a very difficult, if not the most difficult, defensive assignment. And he's just one of those junkyard dog players that a coach loves to have on his team.
He is. And Bob, he won the game. What was it against? Oh, they were already winning by about 12 or 13, but it was in jeopardy. It had been 25-27, and Marquette went to his zone, and Morcell literally on the left side took the game over, and it was fantastic. He here, now on Stevens.
Brockington
made him go right. Not nearly as good going right.
Maryland back within five. Trailed by 10 at halftime. Trailed by 10 not long ago. Stick Smith leans in, uses the window after his own miss, and it drops into the hands of Lamar Stevens.
Same thing. He just went right into Watkins, and Watkins couldn't move.
Stevens cruises to the goal but misses the bunny. Offensive foul call, walling off using the forearm on Stick Smith.
I know it's a good call. It's right in front of us on the line. You're going to see the right arm push off on Brockington right there. That's offensive foul. Easy call.
That's the third on Smith. I'll bring Makai Mitchell back in.
Watkins posted up, but he really didn't want the ball. He should want the ball against Mitchell.
Byron Jones missed him.
Excuse me, Byron.
Brockington. That's no good.
Hard to drive against Morcell. You said it best, man. He is a tough dude.
Wiggins can't hit the three. And Watkins pulls it down.
Well, you'd like to see Penn State take the ball, reverse it a few times, get whatever they want. That's
Flag
bad call.
Foul is called as on the drive, Lamar Stevens got tangled up his feet with the feet of Dante Scott. Dante Scott got called.
I thought Dante Scott was there. He's moving his feet. Yeah, I just tripped.
Well, it looked to me like the foot of Lamar Stevens stepped on the foot of Dante Scott, and Scott fell down.
You're better off just letting that go.
Jones from the corner. Way up in the air for the rebound, Lamar Stevens.
We see him come out on Dre. Dre had the big first half. Great closeout.
Jones tries again, and this time hits a three. Penn State had missed five in a row before that shot.
That's what makes Penn State so difficult. You got Jones out there that can shoot it. Dre out there that can shoot it. We've seen Stevens make a three.
Cowan off balance draws the foul on Jamari Wheeler. If Anthony Cowan stays healthy, goes through the rest of the season, and starts every game this year, he and Jake Layman will be the only two players that Mark Turgeon has ever had at Maryland where they started every single game of their career all the way through for the Terps.
He's just a winning dude.
That's why he came back, he said.
Yeah, he came in with Herder. He came in with, I think it's Justin Jackson. Herder's in the NBA. Jackson's in the G League.
Well, his dad, Anthony Sr., is here. He or his mom, or both, go to every game. Well, the problem is that Anthony's got a younger sister, Alex, who's a guard at Wagner. Actually, friends with my daughter at Wagner. And they have to try and figure out a way, scheduling-wise, where somebody's at every game that the two play. They rack up a lot of miles in the car, going back and forth. Byron Jones gives it back to Stevens. Can't hit the three. Marcel buries a straightaway triple, and that pulls Maryland back to within five once again.
They were playing off. Wheeler was playing off Marcel, and instead of taking the shot when he came down, he waited, got his feet set, got it back, drilled it.
They are daring Wheeler to shoot. He's not even looking at the rim.
Got to go in the watch. Oh.
Wheeler, outside, Dredd. And that's over the backboard. 5-point lead for Penn State. Maryland will have the ball when we come back as we continue the week here on ESPN.
Well, Mike Watkins, a two-prong attack along with Lamar Stevens as seniors. He's been really good today. He's got 12 points. That started the half. He's also blocked shots, and he's done things around the basket to help his teammates. Now, here you're going to see his teammates help him. But Watkins has been very good, and Pat Chambers told us, when that kid is engaged, we are a different basketball team, and I think he's been engaged thus far tonight, 29 minutes worth.
He's a courageous kid. He struggles and has in the past with depression, with a bipolar disorder. He wrote a long introspective article about it and really fought against the stigma. Said, you know, you're growing up and you're growing up with your guys in the hood. You can't reveal things like that for fear of losing that air of toughness. But now he feels like it's something he has to deal with. Get out there, make people aware and say, I'm dealing with it, so can you. In, out, and right back in again for Cowan. And this is the closest that Maryland has been since they were down 14-10 in the first half.
You got to get your hands up on Cowan. I said it in the first half. He's going to shoot that shot. Illinois let him shoot a deep three, and it tied it up. That three-point line moving back means nothing to Anthony Cowan. Zero. You have to get out 3, 4, 5 feet behind it and get your hands up and then move your feet. First half, you saw all kinds of hands all over Cowan. Boy, the freshman Scott down low playing great defense against Watkins.
Stevens gives one up to a cutter in Brockington. He can't hit. Akai Mitchell has it taken away by Brockington, who shovels one to Watkins for the flush.
What a great play by Brockington. Mitchell had the ball. Mitchell was tough and he was physical, but Brockington came from behind, ripped it out, found the next Watkins. He's switching everything, pushing Maryland way out.
Five to shoot. Cowan uses a screen, long three. That won't go. Pulled down by Lamar Stevens.
That's a huge play by Brockington. Maryland had a chance to go tie it up.
Dredd from the corner. Mitchell with a nice outlet to Cowan, over the shoulder, makes the catch, hesitates, pulled the string, challenged by Stevens.
Yeah, Stevens sprinted, got his chin, or excuse me, his head under the backboard. Great defense against Cowan.
Myron Jones in and out, and Makai Mitchell's got the rebound.
Mitchell's playing well, I mean, he is fierce on the backboard. Two freshmen, Scott Mitchell, in the game here for Maryland, playing hard, really hard. Get the ball to Stevens and drive it. He's going to foul. He's tired.
At three short for Cowan. Another rebound for Lamar Stevens. Stevens, hesitation, dribbled it off his own foot, recovered with plenty of time on the shot clock as Myron Jones has it. Jones, quick layup.
What a play by Jones. He knew that the help side defense had their head turned. They didn't even see him coming. He blew by, laid it in.
Timeout called, I believe, by Mark Turgeon.
got to have a head on a swivel when you are in help side. That means you see both. Watch right here. You turn your head, you're out of a stance. Watch right here, 24, I'm sorry. Here comes a blow by. Guys turn their head and they're late. You can't be late in help.
Maryland is number four, down by six here at Penn State, and they are one of four ranked teams in the Big Ten, including 3, 4, and 5 lined up in the top five, Ohio State, Maryland, and a Michigan team that was unranked in the preseason, Michigan State, preseason number one, and they've already lost three games. But that's a pretty good foursome right there.
That's really good, and you see how good the league is by how Penn State's playing here tonight. You'll see Indiana, who beat a very good Florida State team, coming up on ESPN at 9.
Off the timeout, 5 to shoot. Cowan throws it to nowhere. Brockington throws it down.
Cowan involved here.
Cowan to Wiggins. 10 to shoot. Wiggins back to Cowan. For three. What a big shot by Anthony Cowan for Maryland.
They were stuck. Maryland was on 50. Hera had really good defense on Cowan. He just did what he does.
Right.
Lift up and drill it.
What you said.
Yeah.
Rockington blocked. Taken away by Wiggins. Got tied up.
No, that's
Wheeler
a bad
got a
call.
Hand on the ball, and they called traveling on Wiggins.
I don't know how Larry Stroud will let that go. They were all over Wiggins. Pretty good defense if you can get the travel, but my goodness.
And Bo Borowski right now, he's the one that has to deal with Mark Turgeon.
Mark Turgeon better be careful. Man. How's that not a foul?
We'll step aside for a moment. Well, Kevin, it's a night to have either the app going, multiple televisions going, because over on ESPN, Louisville's in trouble. Right here on ESPN2, Maryland's in trouble. 7 minutes to go in our game. Penn State with the 5-point lead. Bob Wischusen, Dan Dockich, and Stevens out of a double team with a skip pass that Dredd can't save.
Boy, that was set up for Dredd, too. Hera had screened in on the backside. Cowan got caught on Stevens. That was set for a wide open three. That's a big play, big misplay by Penn State. They had a wide open look for Dredd had they delivered the ball.
19 Maryland turnovers, though, and as a result, 19 more field goal attempts. Woo! Block at the rim by Harris. A challenge again, but a foul call. And it looks like Stick Smith will head to the free throw line.
Assistant coaches at Maryland getting a little crazy. Beano over there, up. Larry Scrotto, Bo Borowski will take it from that man, but they're not going to take it from assistant coaches.
Two shots.
Donald's All-American out of high school. Two-time Maryland Gatorade Player of the Year. And a 75% free throw shooter that misses the front end.
Here's your screen to screener action on the reverse. Watkins down screen Dredd. Didn't happen because Wiggins playing hard defensively.
And a takeaway. Morcell picks the pocket of Lamar Stevens. In the corner, Wiggins. Off the front rim. Watkins has the rebound. Here comes Stevens on a run out. And he waits for some help. Byron Jones floats one up. That won't go. Another rebound for Morcell.
Look at Morcell blocking out Watkins.
Callum. Cowan is fouled by Myron Jones. So Maryland goes to the free throw line as both teams are now over the limit. We'll check that. Maryland only with four team fouls. It's a 1-1 off the seventh Penn State team foul. Anthony Cowan tested the draft and was told by those prognosticators, the best thing you can do for yourself, just got to get stronger. And so he has added 10 pounds of muscle. And Mark Turgeon said it really has made a difference in his game.
And he's having fun. I mean, I've done five of the last six. I can't believe he's missed three free throws. It's unbelievable. I think I've done four or five of the last six games of Maryland. And talking to him, he's having an absolute blast. Loves his teammates. And so much more fun playing on this environment than playing in a G League or playing somewhere in Yugoslavia or wherever.
Morsell just committed the 15th foul for Maryland. And it looked like he simply got a hand in on the backdoor pass. He can't believe this was called a foul. Let's have another look.
He had two hands on him. Hard to tell. Bo Borowski's right there.
Watkins has to be careful. Wiggins was lurking. And Morsell almost got a steal. Five to shoot. Byron Jones. It's tied up. Two to shoot. Out to the wing. Brockington hits the timer and buries a three.
That's how you beat a top five team at home. Shots like that, because Morsell played great defense. Brockington just lifted up over it.
Morsell gets a return. Eight on the shot clock for the Terps. Anthony Cowan uses the screen. Three to shoot. He's going to have to force one up. Too strong.
Great defense. They came out the ball screen, but Dredd was just going to switch it. So Cowan didn't want the ball screen there, and they forced him into a tough shot. Great adjustment by Pat Chambers, having Dredd guarding the ball screen.
Byron Jones, yes. Mark Turgeon wants a timeout.
He needs a timeout, and he needs to get Lindo out of there.
Five different players in double figures for Penn State. Can the Nittany Lions hold on and take down number four? We're about to find out. Oh, Kevin. Student section right behind us senses the opportunity for Penn State, as the Nittany Lions have not beaten a top five team since February of 2016, when they took down Iowa. With Patrick Chambers as the head coach, they've played 67 ranked teams now. In the previous 66 games, they're 14-52. That doesn't sound so good, but 14 wins against ranked opponents. That's the most for any head coach in Penn State basketball history. 66 games against ranked opponents is the most for any head coach in Penn State history. And for a long time, this wasn't a very good basketball program. So the fact that they are doing what we almost expected them to do, Dan, against the fourth-ranked team in America is testament to how good this team could be.
No question. And this team deserves to have this kind of fan support every night out. Boy, what a lazy pass. They had three right there.
Wiggins fades away.
Great defense.
In and out.
Great defense by Watkins.
And it looks like a foul is called. That should put Stick Smith at the line. As Lamar Stevens is called for the foul. Well, tonight after the Jimmy V Classic, stick around. It's SportsCenter with SVP. They'll have highlights and reactions from all of the top basketball teams playing in college hoops tonight, plus Sixers and Heat both looking to remain unbeaten at home. And one of our favorite segments, Where in the World Isn't SVP? Scott Van Pelt, SportsCenter after Indiana-UConn over on ESPN and, as always, on the ESPN app.
I caught him last night with bad beats, man. I'm telling you. SVP is, I say it all the time, he's the Johnny Carson of our generation. He's just smooth, funny, fun, and Stanford Steve, I don't know if he's Ed McMahon, the modern version of Ed McMahon.
How about the free throw attempts tonight? The home team hasn't been to the line. And the road team has scored 14 and now 15 points of their 57 at the free throw line.
Here's a little press. Mark Turgeon, mostly a man-to-man guy, but he's not afraid to change it up, and he almost had. Now you got to play two-on-one.
Stevens tried to throw it down and got fouled. Jalen Smith stood his ground as best he could. But Lamar Stevens, the leading returning scorer and rebounder in the Big Ten, going to the line for the first time.
And Pat Chambers is screaming, and was screaming at Larry Scrotto. Now he's telling Bo Borowski, it's the first two free throws we've had. It's the first two.
And now those two are getting together to clean the court.
Actually, it was one of the assistants telling Bo Borowski. Chambers got a piece of Larry Scurato pointing two. That's a first two all day.
Allen splits a double team.
Ball to Wiggins when he's been open on time.
An air ball from Cowan, recovered by Wiggins. Here's Ayala. That hit the backboard first. Long rebound to Wiggins. Cowan tries again. Another long rebound. Stick Smith is fouled.
Yeah, he's fouled by Lamar Stevens, who yanked on the jersey of Stick Smith as he was jumping out to get the basketball.
That's the fourth on Lamar Stevens.
Pat Chambers doesn't want a fourth call on Stevens, but it's the absolute right call.
Number 25, Jalen Smith at the line for Maryland. 1-1.
Stick Smith was Big Ten All-Freshman last season, averaged about 11.5 points a game. And this year, not only is he up to 13.5 points a game, but he's averaging a double-double through the first 10 for Maryland. 13 points, 10 rebounds a game. Got a pair up the line.
Number four, Ricky Lindo Jr.
Surprised that they're bringing Lindo back in?
A little bit. They went right at Lindo last time he was in the game. He's been an active kid today, but they went right at him for a layup last time he was in the game.
Three minutes to go. Jones turns the corner. Got caught. Good hands by Morsell.
This is where 11 seconds, you just play without fouling. If you're Maryland.
And State will call a timeout. So they have two remaining. Maryland has one. This has been a fun, emotional game.
Every home game should be like this for these kids from Penn State. They play hard, they play enthusiastic, and they play a fun style. And you can see Mark Turgeon, man, he's trying to get back in this as best he can, but he's just a coach.
Maryland has not led for even 90 seconds in this game. They have had a tough time getting their best players open look. So if you're trying to generate some offense and come from behind and pull this off again, what are you doing if you're Mark Turgeon?
Well, if you're Mark Turgeon, you want Cowan involved. And I think this, I think both Cowan and Wiggins, if they can get a look from three against help defense, a shot fake will clear them, or they can jump in and they will get three free throws. I promise you, that's what you want to do. They've had both Wiggins and Cowan open, actually Wiggins twice, and the ball wasn't delivered to them. Those are the two guys, and then everybody crashed the glass. And you don't foul if you're Maryland on this end of the court.
Well, they're out of fouls to give.
And I'm not letting him beat me. I got to go double him right now from Wiggins. His man's out of it.
Instead of fadeaway. And
it is pure once again for Lamar Stevens.
I say it every game. Bill Belichick picks out two or three ambient guys, guys that keep you up at night, and they're not going to beat him. For the Patriots, you can't let Stevens beat you.
Short-armed it.
Wiggins can't answer. Lamar Stevens, he's got 14 points and another rebound.
You got to go right back to Stevens here mid-post. He's comfortable on the left side. Go to him.
In and out for Jones. Watkins couldn't keep it alive long enough on the offensive glass. And now Larry Scarato says my time. Might be a timing issue with the clock. Maryland has missed eight in a row, and they have made only one of their last 12 from the field, and yet this is still a game, single digits with 2:25 remaining.
Maryland has to get Cowan. Shot clock issue is what they're saying. Maryland has to get Cowan an angle and then play out of it, meaning you're going to have guys come to help. Clock stopped here.
And just stayed frozen during this entire possession.
That's a long time.
So they'll probably take about 10 or 12 seconds off the clock, I would think.
Here's the other thing. With your, if you're what'd you say Maryland has missed? Like eight in a row? Or?
They've missed eight in a row, and they've made one of their last 12 from the field.
All right, it's the same thing I'm talking about with Maryland. If you are Penn State, don't foul. Make a team that is ice cold make a shot. So many times you see a defensive team in this situation get overly aggressive. Don't foul if you're Penn State. Move your feet, keep them in front of you, and everybody get on the backboard. But I'm telling you, on an offensive rebound, if I'm guarding Cowan, I'm staying with Cowan. I am not going to the backboard. I'm staying with him because when Maryland rebounds it, they'll kick it, and it's three. Same with Wiggins.
Wiggins was a shot fake and a step back.
No, he missed it. He had him in the air, could have gone into him and gotten three shots, but he didn't do it.
10 rebounds for Mike Watkins. He's got a double-double. And a foul call. Wiggins and checking Myron Jones, so Jones will go to the line.
The help came. This is what Turgeon's exasperated about. The help came from the defender's right. And instead of moving over to his left to pin the man in, got beat to the right by Jones, and Jones going to go shoot two. Because he's not missing the first one.
So far this season, he is their second-best free-throw shooter.
Watch what I'm talking about here. Okay, the defender's here. The help's coming this way. So the defender needs to get on this side. But watch what happens. Here comes the help. He's there, and then he reaches and gets off balance, and now he has to use his hands. You show your hands, make a ball handler go to help, and you've got a trap.
A double-digit lead for Penn State against number four Maryland. Coming up on a minute and a half to go. Cowan got caught in midair, and Brockington takes it away. Brockington can't finish. Gets fouled hard by Wiggins.
How good has Brockington been in this game on both ends? I'll tell you how good. He's been great. He's knocked in big shots. He's defended. He's stolen. And he's chased all game long.
I think Patrick Chambers wants a flagrant foul to be called against Maryland. That didn't seem like anyone else on the Penn State bench reacted nearly as angrily as the head coach did. Even the players on the floor. They went over to help up Brockington, but Patrick Chambers was livid, and now you see Keith Kimball and Bo Borowski is going to go over to the monitor, and they will take a look at the foul to see if this should be excessive.
He's going to block a shot. Right here, Wiggins is going up. He thinks he has a Dwayne Wade type pin. He happens to hit him on the arm. Play on, let's go, no worries. Great play by Brockington, though. He's been fantastic. This team, Penn State, deserves to have a crowd every night in the Big Ten. I'm not talking about, you know, against whomever. I'm talking about in the Big Ten home games, this place should be electric.
The officiating crew has now come away from the monitor.
There's nothing to talk about.
They're having a longer conversation than you would think if it was that cut and dry.
Two shots.
And now Bo Borowski, I think, is going to make his way over here after he tells Mark Turgeon and the Maryland huddle what the call is. He'll come over and fill in Dan Dokich.
Hi, Bo.
Basketball.
Yeah. Just a play. Why are you wasting our time? Why'd you waste our time?
I think it's a fair question you asked.
Yeah, I mean, what are we doing? Hey, look, you see that all the time. Dwayne Wade, LeBron James coming from behind, making the block. That's all that Wiggins did. He just happened to get him on the arm, and it looked worse than it was.
So a sophomore from Philadelphia, Isaiah Brockington, sat out last year after transferring from St. Bonaventure. And he was only a player that scored about 4.5 points a game at St. Bonaventure a couple of years ago. Now he's a 9 point per game scorer off the bench of the Big Ten.
Atlantic 10's harder than the Big Ten, some might say. Or he took advantage of a year off and really worked on his game. He's been terrific. He and Wheeler both. Wheeler has no stats, number five, but he's been terrific. Jeez, I don't know why he just didn't give Cowan the ball, and how's that not a foul?
And it is, as Ayala will go to the free throw line.
You know, if you want to, from our vantage point, see what's supposed to happen, you look at the coach. Cowan came back up, was supposed to get the ball. Ayala didn't get it to him, and Mark Turgeon lost his mind a little bit, turned away. Frustrating game for him. Not a frustrating game for Penn State. They've been great.
Twelve now for Ayala. That's the first time he scored the second half. Lamar Stevens in for Mike Watkins. So you got a 72% free throw shooter in the game, and you have the 57% free throw shooter sit down.
Now, you got to figure you're going to foul, trap, try to steal, and then foul. Man, Wiggins didn't see Dredd.
Ooh! Traveling is called.
Yeah, sure was.
Lamar Stevens turns it over.
You've got four guards out there. Rockington, Wheeler, Dredd, Jones, and Stevens is handling the basketball. You can't have it. Now, if you're Maryland, you don't need a three here. You'd like a three. But to extend this game, you go to the rim, Bobby, you might get a three-point play, or...
Ayala finds Cowan on the back cut. Oh, stood up by Watkins, no call.
Watkins went up, and I thought he went into Cowan, but Watkins with a great play.
Wheeler gets it across. From the corner, a three, in and out for Miles Dredd. Not a shot that Penn State needed. Wiggins gives it up to Stick Smith.
That shot would have ended the game.
And there is a foul given by Maryland in the backcourt.
What Turgeon's talking about there is on the drive. He feels Mike Watkins didn't go straight up and went forward with his hands, thus violating verticality.
Lamar Stevens back in the game for Penn State.
Two free throws made. You miss this one, you go down and get a bucket, we got a ball game. Students getting ready to rush the court.
Now, this is why they had Mike Watkins subbing out possession by possession with Lamar Stevens, because Patrick Chambers did not want Mike Watkins to be the player at the line.
But you know what? You said it. He's a senior, he's been through a lot.
Calmly knocks down the first at 57%.
Yeah, he did. This place is going to get crazy in about 41 seconds.
Wow. One of two.
Same thing. You go quick, you get a three, great. If not, you go lay it in. They have to find another possession.
Ayala will attack the rim, and that's blocked by Watkins. Ayala's down. And he is slow to get up.
Now that time, there is no argument. Watkins just went straight up and spiked it. Watkins has great timing. Great timing. Shot blockers aren't just big. They got to have timing, and he does.
Oh, plus the man. Foul for Wiggins. Cowan and Wiggins caught Penn State napping for a three-point play with 30 seconds to go.
Trent and Stevens, watch them. I'm sorry, Brockington and Stevens. Nobody knew who had who. They both fell asleep. Wow.
If Wiggins knocks this down, things could really get interesting in the last 30 seconds. Can't make it, but the back tap. Out near midcourt, Jones saves it. And a foul given by Cowan on Lamar Stevens.
Ooh, Penn State dodged one right there because that would have been open court. And Cowan gets that ball. That's an open three.
That's the 10th team foul on Maryland. So an automatic two for Lamar Stevens. And of late, as you can see, he has been just about automatic.
He's terrific. You know, again, another kid tested the NBA, came back. He's going to move up all of the... He's going to be one of the all-time best players in the history of this school. Got to just go.
Ayala hesitates around Watkins. Draws a foul.
The crowd can boo all they want, but once Watkins smacks down a little bit, it's going to be a foul. Tell you what, Watkins pretty good in the back of everything.
If Penn State can hold on, it would be the 15th ranked win with Coach Chambers on the sideline, and it would be the third time of those 15 wins against ranked opponents that the victim has been Maryland.
Home team wins this series, huh?
The last six, this would be seven in a row. They've alternated wins on each other's home floor.
I mean, what the inbound, you gotta follow me. We can't let time go off. Penn State's giving them a chance by missing.
Last year though, when Penn State beat Maryland here, Maryland was ranked number 17. Just feels different when there's that single digit, much less a four, next to the opponent in the score box.
And undefeated.
Home run pass, Brockington. And he is fouled. 18 seconds to go.
You know, it's amazing. How many times on dead balls, this is the third time, we've seen the defense not be ready. Ball was inbounded because nobody saw Dredd. Ball was inbounded for a three-point play just now, and then right here, nobody got to Brockington. He misses this. You get the ball into Collins' hands in an open court, set a ball screen. He's got to take a three, see what, figure out what happens. He makes it. You can do the same thing, too.
Down by six, maybe seven. It seems like the time that you had to take the ball to the rim, that might
be now over. You got
to
go.
Now you got to think about three-pointers.
Yep, I think so. And if you're Penn State, you don't leave anybody. You stay on top of the wings. And you know what? If you want to go to the rim, go to the rim.
Well, Morcell is going to go to the rim. Blocked. Watkins hands it off to Wheeler. Here comes Brockington. 10 seconds to go. And now the crowd really will celebrate here in Happy Valley.
Penn State deserved this win. They played harder from the get-go, Bob. They came right at the undefeated Terps. They got what they deserved tonight.
Penn State has forced 20 turnovers, and they've scored 22 points off of the 20 turnovers that they have forced. Maryland digs themselves an early hole, and it was really the sloppy play in the first half that's cost them. And now a foul given sloppily in the backcourt by Jamari Wheeler.
Jamari Wheeler's been good. He's been really good. I'm not sure, and maybe I missed this, and you see unranked teams wins. I'm not sure I've ever heard music played during a game like this.
This is the pre-celebration.
Music. Look at all these. How about Stephen of Austin at the buzzer? We did the Purdue-Virginia game, and that was a rout. And there's no way Virginia was a top five team. There you go.
Six seconds to go, and then they will celebrate here at the Bryce Jordan Center. And the officials, they're going to let the clock wind down. Penn State takes down number four. Party is on here at Penn State, 76-69. They take down Maryland. For Dan Dock and John Bob Bushusen, thanks for joining us. Coming up next, it's Butler and Baylor.